What's up, guys? So we're here at Kiss Me Muscle. What day is today? Wednesday afternoon. So we're like two and a bit days out because we're on stage Friday night. So we're just getting our last kind of like upper body pump circuit kind of thing. So not really to like build muscle or tear up muscle or anything like that. More just to start moving the food around because we started putting the carbs back in a little bit yesterday. So just to like, you know, keep everything kind of going where it should. We're just doing like a light upper body thing. So we're doing like two sets and two exercises for each part. So like, say for back, we'll do like a pull down or a pull over and a row movement. For chest, we'll do like a fly and a press. And then two arm movements, that kind of stuff. Two sets of everything, kind of the 12 rep range. Not going to failure, but probably like 80%, 85%. So like getting a good squeeze and making it difficult, but maybe leaving like two or three reps in the tank. So we're gonna finish this up here. We're just doing our last little bit of arm stuff. And then I have my athletes meeting tonight at 7 o'clock. So I think it's like almost six now or something. Yeah, 6:10. So we'll finish up here. We'll go back, get our post-workout meal in, and then we'll head over to the host hotel or the convention center, wherever that is. We have our athletes meeting. So then that's where we like give our music, check in, get our button numbers, see all that kind of stuff. That kind of tells the flow of the show, what the schedule is. And then we also get our fancy tracksuits that we get every year. And because we're the men's open, we're like the real cool people. We get the ones with our actual names on it, not like the half-assed ones that Chris Bumstead gets, you know? So we get the good ones. So we'll head over there for 7. Hopefully we can bring you guys along for that. If not, we'll kill whoever we need to get you in. And then we'll go from there. So we'll see you guys in a bit. Guys, so we just finished up at the gym there. Like I said, just a little, I hate using the word like upper body pump, but I guess that's kind of what it is. Just like a circuit, like, you know, a little bit of everything, like I said.
Get the carbs moving.
Just to get the carbs moving, get a little blood, and like keep yourself in that routine. Like my body is used to, you know, having nutrients come in, being, you know, the blood move around, getting a little bit of sweating. And that's just part of the process for like helping my body stay dry and keep nutrients moving, like I said. So we finished that up now. We're a little tight for the working on right. We're a little tight for time here. It's 6:17, and the athletes' meeting is at 7. So we're just getting back to the Airbnb here, and I'll get my post workout in. So I think right after training, I have just like a scoop of isolate and some rice cakes and jam. So we'll have that in a minute, and then Melissa has my post workout meal ready, which is beef and rice, and we'll bring that on the road. So I'll eat that as we go there. And then we'll go do the athletes meeting. And I think after that, actually, because today's Wednesday, I'm on stage Friday night. I've started my tan quite a bit earlier. So we'll start tanning tonight, actually, too. So I got to do the whole fucking shit process of shaving down and starting tans tonight. So that's always a treat. Anyway, any guy that has a decent amount of body hair knows that that can be
the worst part.
The worst part, especially when you're already kind of tired. And then you're like, oh, I got to stand here for 2 hours while I shave all this shit off. But luckily, since I just did the Arnold 2 weeks ago and I've kept it like relatively groomed, it's not too bad, but it's still a process. And especially when you have your wife doing your back, they can be like a little bit perfectionist with it. So like, I want to just be like quick, quick, quick. And she'll be like so intricate. And I'm like, yo, no one's going to see that 3 fucking hairs from 15 rows back. So, but I appreciate the effort. So, yeah, we'll just get back to the Airbnb here and then we'll head to the athletes meet.
Oh, yours is perfect, to be honest.
It's good?
Yeah.
Okay. It's always brighter than you think, you know?
Yeah. That was great.
Good?
Yep.
gonna go on the carpet so I can get the burger.
Ooh, look at the quads, eh?
Yeah. I do feel like Patrick's probably right. You can have a bit more food.
Yeah.
Oh. But he's so strong, he destroyed the garage door. There you go. Nobody knows. All fit.
Super dry, eh?
Yeah. The front shot, yeah, a little shot, through the upper chest.
Just, yeah, just upper chest a bit. Back, you can see like.
Yeah.
Here a bit.
Yeah. Like, glutes are drier than this morning.
Yeah,
though.
For sure.
This is nice light, eh?
Yeah.
It's so crispy. That's good. I like that look a lot. Good.
That's the Patrick Tour Update 3 Pose Wonder I do. Yeah. Front, side, back, done.
Yeah, everything there.
Yeah.
All right, so we just did our quick little update after training that we'll send off to Patrick, to my coach. So we've had 3 meals today, and then he'll take a look at that, and we can see if we need to increase or decrease the food. Both Julie and I think that he'll probably want to add a little more. The conditioning is improving, and the fullness is building, but with how much the dryness is improving, we can obviously handle a bit more food, and we can still see, even after with a little pump, there's still a little bit of flatness in the upper chest and in the lower lats. So there's definitely plenty of room there for more food without sacrificing any condition whatsoever. So we'll get moving. Melissa, like the good wife she is, USB with the music ready to go, meal ready to go, Game Boy ready to go. Everything you need for a bodybuilding athletes meeting right there. So. I'll get my rice cakes and jam, eat that here, and then we'll bring that meal for the road. So, all right. So we got 3 of these bad boys, and 30, 50 grams of jam, I think it is. And then we'll have a scoop of the raw. For you guys haven't tried this yet, we got the new C-Bum with raw ISO here. So this is the cinnamon crunch cereal. This stuff tastes amazing. If you guys haven't tried this, go get your hands on it, because I know, like, anyone knows that anything with Chris's name on it sells out in like 30 fucking seconds. So if there is any left, which at this point there might not even be, I have no idea, go try some of this. There's this, and then there's the vanilla oatmeal cookie, I think it is. Both of them taste ridiculously good. This is my favorite personally. I really like the more like sweeter, a little stronger flavors, not the lighter stuff. But if you like lighter, you know, more, you know, neutral flavors. I don't like to use neutral, but something that, you know, you can use it all like in everything. You know, using your oats, using your coffee, stuff like that. The vanilla is for you. If you want something a little sweeter, especially when you're in prep and you want that like sweet fix, the cinnamon crunch cereal is amazing. So we're gonna scoop this in. And don't forget to use my code Iain, I-A-I-N.
My shirts?
Yeah.
No, these, they were supposed to be done on Monday.
I
this is Iain's trick during prep to relax. Catch Pokemons.
Any good?
What?
Any good?
Oh yeah, anyone looking to compete definitely needs to be a Pokemon catcher.
Good. Okay. Time to get crumbs all over the BMW.
Yep. It's not mine. Don't care.
Right?
There we go.
Got the fresh ones out.
All right, guys, so we just finished the athletes meeting there. I said it would probably be 15 minutes, and it would end up being like an hour. Shows what I know. Wishful thinking, I guess. So we finished up there. I'm number 8. Usually I'm near the end of the pack, so this is kind of a nice change for me, kind of being more mid-pack. So I'm looking forward to that. I think I'm between Regan Grimes, so another fellow Canadian's number 7, and then Hottie Chupin is number 9. So I got a cool little, like, you know, polar opposite physiques on either side of me in both directions, so that'll be really cool. I'm looking forward to that. So we're getting our fourth meal in now. We got beef and rice, and then we're gonna go back, and then Patrick increased the food a little bit for our next two meals. After seeing my post-workout, the conditioning's, like I said, really good, and kind of like Julie and I speculated that he might increase a little bit, so we just bumped up the carbs a tiny, tiny bit for the last two meals. Just to get a little more full in this building there. Conditioning's in a really, really good spot, but we want to keep, especially through the back shots, make sure that that pop is really starting to build. So, but other than that, we're super happy with how things are going. We're going to finish up here. I think Julian went to get his tickets. We'll wait for him to get back, and we'll head back to the Airbnb, start shaving down, get that tan going tonight. So, looking forward to that. Red and black.
Oh, your swag.
Oh my God, they gave me a 2XL.
I told you.
I told them I need the biggest size, so that must be. They're nice though. It's the same as the first year one, the heavy ones.
Maybe the 2XL of this is an average 2XL. It's not your average 2XL.
No, that's a big 2XL.
No, that's the pants.
I'm so good.
The 2XL pants will fit.
No, it's XL plus.
XXL plus.
It's a super size 2XL.
And then what do we got? Socks.
Oh, you even got socks.
Oh, fancy.
Shit.
Full swag.
They stepped up the budget this year. Oh. Yeah, between Regan and Hottie.
Oh, yeah?
Regan 7, Hottie's 9. That's okay. Good. It's a good spot. What do you guys want up here?
Exciting.
I did kick him out.
Maybe they're made bigger.
No, but this written 2XL plus.
Plus.
Oh, so maybe that's just
XXL
their
plus.
Size. Where's the pants? And does it say your name on it? Oh, cool. Oh, nice.
The pants are nice too.
Looks, oh, the pants are really nice.
Looks way better than last
time. Yeah. It's not as heavy as the first one,
try
but
on the pants.
Camera's on, dropping trowel.
This is bodybuilding. This is normal stuff.
We've seen much more than this.
Yeah.
I like it.
The pants feel a little small, but
no,
they're
kind of
short feeling. No, they're not.
No.
No, they're good.
No, they're not small.
Definitely.
It's just the front. watch that's not as long as you're used to, I think.
Yeah, it looks nice.
Yeah, maybe. Yeah, that's very nice.
All right, guys, so we're back at the Airbnb now. We got the athletes being done, so I got two more meals. We're gonna have meal five now, so I got 500 potato and some fish, right? And then some added fats, that, and then we got another meal after that. Things are going in a good direction. Like I said, we increased the food a little bit just to keep pushing the fullness. I'm gonna get this meal in me, and then it's 9 o'clock and I gotta start shaving, which is a fucking pain in the ass. So get the shaving done. We're gonna get one or two coats on tonight, and then we'll be back tomorrow and we'll film some of the getting sprayed with Pro-Tan stuff for that, so you guys can kind of see behind the scenes on that. But yeah, tomorrow I think it's a pretty low-key day. We got the meet the pros in the evening, but no training, no cardio. We're done all that now. So it'll be mostly a day of just relaxing, posing, eating. A little bit of excitement in the evening with the meet the pros, which obviously will take you guys along for the ride for that. But yeah, we'll see you guys tomorrow. Seems to be pretty happy. Hey, good, how are you doing?
Where?
Yeah. Yeah, I'm just about to eat meal two now.
One meal is fluid, and I can see the difference in the back, especially.
Yeah.
Yeah,
we both Julie and I agreed the fullness is better in the back, but there's still some room to go, like through obviously the upper chest and stuff, but that's only, like you said, one meal deep today, so it's still tons of room to go there.
Absolutely, and then also, you know, tomorrow
we have all day, basically. Yeah.
Four meals today, and
yeah.
Yeah. Yeah, so awesome. I mean, that's
yeah.
Like,
yeah, no, I really like the look, and that posing, like how we've been doing it, is it makes that shot look so much better too.
Yeah, that front lat spread, actually really always liked it. But
yeah.
Like this, if you can really get it like this, it's fantastic.
Yeah.
Absolutely. Nobody will beat you in that front lat spread.
Yeah.
Maybe Brandon Curry gets close, but he doesn't have the legs yet. So
yeah.
Fantastic.
Cool.
Awesome.
Awesome. Really, yeah. So I'll have meal two now and then touch base with you in a little bit. I said I'll have meal two now and then touch base with you in a couple hours. Okay, we'll talk to you in a bit. Okay, bye. All right, so we just talked to Patrick, to the coach there. Very happy with the way things are going. Level of fullness is building already from this morning just with the one meal. So we're gonna continue meal two as planned with a little more carbs than we had with meal two yesterday. And then I think we're gonna go back to just the same meals that we did yesterday with the 100 grams of rice. I think that's what the plan was. But what we'll do is we'll get this meal in. We're gonna get another coat of tan on. We're going to go print some things at Staples, and then we'll get another update and see how that second meal sat and kind of how things have changed after that. We'll go from there. So, what is up?
You talk like CRISPR when you start YouTube.
Yeah, I mean, he says, what is up, YouTube?
Yeah.
Mine's like a joke now because I started saying that and people were like, oh, we're waiting for you to say the what is up YouTube like Chris. So now I like almost do it, but not all the way there. So it's like always a little tease, you know?
Teaser.
It's a tease. So it's, what time is it now? 6:21. So we actually are late. We're headed to the Meet the Pros right now. So that runs from 7 to 9. I think they asked the athletes to be there at like 6:30-ish, but it's not the end of the world. So 7 to 9, they have the Meet the Pros. That's kind of like where there's, you know, athletes all have their tables with like their little name things that is set up by the Olympia. And the fans and people that bought tickets for this event can come through and get photos or autographs or buy merchandise, personal merchandise from any of the athletes that are there and that have it. So we got some pictures done up this afternoon. So we got a couple different ones there. We'll be signing and doing that.
$50.
They're free. we have next coat of tan tonight at 10 o'clock. So we'll finish up at 7 to 9, I think it runs, for the Meet the Pros. And then we'll head to the tan right after that because it's over on that side of town or in the same venue, right?
Yep.
So we'll get that done. We'll bring you guys along for the ride there. Carb-wise, food-wise, we've started to we actually are pushing the pace a little heavier now. So we were getting some good build on the fullness, but the dryness and pop is just improving with it. So if we can push the pace a little more, I mean, maybe he can even explain.
Yeah, we can push the pace like a bit more so that if we need to, we can kind of scale back tomorrow. And if we do need even more food, well, then at least we'll have what's added tonight to go with.
Exactly. So instead of leaving it till tomorrow morning, it's a little too late, and then we're trying to pile in more food than is comfortable for me tomorrow and trying to play catch up on Saturday morning or Friday by Friday night, you know? So we want to make sure we have a good base built tonight. If we need to scale back, we can do so, or reduce water a bit to get a little out. But you don't want to do it better safe than sorry and better late. Like, you don't want to do it too late, right?
We're also trying to reproduce, like, when you're doing a pre-judging in the, like, at noon.
Yes.
So tomorrow you'll be posing a lot, so the extra carbs from tonight are going to be used tomorrow for sure.
Yeah, so the science behind that really was we've obviously found that I end up being a lot better for evening shows. And I think a lot of that has to do with stress, but I also think a lot of that has to do with getting on stage once, posing, getting my heart rate up, getting a little bit of sweat, getting a little bit of water, and then relaxing after that. So we're gonna kind of mimic that for tomorrow. So because the pre-judging is at 7 p.m., what we're gonna do is, like Julian said, wake up, have a couple meals, mimic like a morning pre-judge, where we'll run through the poses until I'm getting hot and getting good sweat on, like as if it was pre-judging. And then after that, I can take my nap, you know, keep going with food and pretend that that pre-judging at night is a morning show, and we've replicated the process in the morning to, you know, perfect things for looking good at the evening or at evening pre-judging. Yeah. So,
which is going to be kind of like when you have your finals.
Exactly. Yeah. Which would usually be with finals. And then again, on Saturday, we're later in the day as well. So that's beneficial for me both days, in my opinion. So, but yeah, we'll get headed to that athletes meet the pros now and get some food. Food wise, yeah, I said that we increased. We only increased by about another 20%, 15%. Yeah. So like meals that were 120 oats went to 150, meals that were, you know, 100 rice went to 120, so about 20% increase. And then, yeah, we'll probably give you guys a visual update later out of the hotel over there, before or after I get tanned. And yeah, we'll see you in a bit. So we just finished at the Meet the Pros. It was a really good turnout. I mean, there was a ton of people there, which was kind of cool to see, you know, after obviously last year there not being any Meet the Pros or real expo or anything like that. So to have that back this year was really cool. A lot of people came out and supported, so that's awesome. So it's like almost 10 now, 9:43. So we spent like a good part of 3 hours there almost. So we're tired, we're ready to eat, that's for damn sure. So we're gonna go find a microwave here so I can cook my food, because I think I have oats this meal, and then we're gonna go get tanned. So we got one more tan. Hopefully I didn't sweat like three quarters of what I have on here off of that Meet the Pros, but I think I'm all right. So we're just walking through the convention center here. We're gonna get up to the hotel where Protan is. Do we even know where Protan is?
Yeah.
Okay. All right, we'll figure it out, and then we'll see you guys in a little bit.
Seconds,
it's just not happening.
look what I did. Can I be in it?
Of course.
Yeah, of course you can. Good. This is like cheerleader effect. It makes me look better looking by having a good looking woman with me, you know?
It's actually ugly girls.
No, it's just more ugly girls together make them all look better looking.
Do I look crazy right now?
No, you look good.
Okay. Yeah. You know when you're like awake for 17 hours?
Hi, we're the Valliere's.
Hi, we're the Valliere Bumsteads.
No. That nonsense. All right, so we just got finished with our tan. So that was like our third coat. We've done two light coats at home. This is the first one we got like actually sprayed, so we're starting to get like some good color on there now. We had my fifth meal before, which was the oats and some turkey. And now we're gonna head back and have the last meal.
Is it potato?
Potato and eggs and egg whites.
I made like 700 grams potato and he's eating like
300?
None.
300?
I peeled a lot of potatoes for no fucking reason.
It'll be used tomorrow. It's all good. Save us time tomorrow. We just find that the potatoes stick a little better for me and like maintain my fullness a little better. So we've been having those for the later meals. And they don't sit quite as well during the day. So we have overnight to let them digest. If they don't feel great, it'll be good by the morning. And they hold the fullness a lot better for us overnight versus like a white rice or something. So that's just something we've kind of found trial and error. So that's why we're having that with the eggs. And I think there's some like nut butter, macadamia nuts or something there just for a little bit more added fat to kind of slow it down. But other than that, things are great. We're in
a
good spot.
We had so much fun.
Yeah, the Meet the Pros was a ton of fun. Like I already talked on there, I mean, it was a huge turnout. It was really fun. And, you know, it's just...
They want to leave, so say goodbye.
Yeah. It was
no,
a lot of fun.
Them. Say goodbye to them. Oh, never mind.
I'll say goodbye here anyways. But yeah, we'll be back tomorrow. We got another tan sometime tomorrow morning.
Yep.
Then we're going to just be eating, relaxing. And prejudging starts at 7. We're the last class, I believe. So I'm probably on stage like 8, 8:30, 9, something like that. But we'll see you guys tomorrow. Posing, tanning, eating, all that same shit that bodybuilders do every single day.
Winning at life.
Yeah.
Living the dream.
See you guys tomorrow. What is up, guys? We're back today. It's Friday, so the day of prejudging. We're on stage tonight. The event starts at 7, but I think we're like closer to the end, if not last. So probably 9:30, maybe even 10 o'clock we'll be on. So it's noon right now, so we got like 10 hours till stage time. We just got another coat of tan done this morning. So I did one Wednesday night ourselves, like hand done, one Thursday morning by ourselves, hand done, and then we got sprayed last night, which is the first spray. I slept in all that, those three coats, and then I rinsed off this morning to like anything that wasn't soaked into the skin, get that kind of like muddy excess off. I find that makes a big difference for the quality of my tans. Some people it doesn't and they need all that coat on them. For me, I look 100% better with a fresh tan, like over once I rinse off. So so now we got one on this morning. We've had one meal so far. We kept the food relatively high like yesterday, so it was 140 oats, some beef, whole eggs, so a little higher fats than yesterday, and a banana, so still pushing the carbs pretty good. Next meal we're about to have here will be meal two, but first we're gonna pose to make sure everything's going as we want and hope and expect based off meal one. So we'll take a quick look here, and then we'll have meal two, which tentatively is 120 rice with beef, I believe. But we'll confirm that in a couple minutes with Patrick after we send him the posing video here. So we gotta do that. Then I have another tan as late as I possibly can. I think 6 o'clock, we'll probably head over there for the tan, get the last tan done, and then hang out or go backstage at that point kind of thing. But I don't think there's any point going backstage at 6:30, 7 o'clock for an event that starts at 7 when I'm last. So, and they also have 212 routines tonight, fitness routines tonight.
Yep. Finals for wellness.
Finals for wellness. So like there's some things that have posing routines, which could be, you know, 10 competitors doing 3-minute routines plus time between plus redoing callouts. So you'd be talking about an hour per class at least. So I mean, if there's two classes before us, plus then just a quick final awards for one other, I mean, you could be talking, yeah, 2 hours, 2.5 hours.
Yeah, there's four classes.
Four classes, but only two have posing routines.
Yeah.
So
So that'll take longer, obviously, than just coming on and doing their walk and then doing awards. So, but yeah, probably 9:30 or so. So get a couple more meals in. Ideally, we get 4 good meals in and then maybe like 1 or 2 small ones. Just to let the stomach sit a little better, like getting right close to the show. But yeah, that's the plan for today. We'll see you soon. All right, guys, so we finished up doing a couple rounds, 4 or 5 rounds of posing there. What we were really trying to do is like mimic a typical morning prejudge. And I think that's part of the process for me to really dry out and get that crisp look that I generally can bring much better to the night show. So we were trying to replicate kind of like a prejudging this morning. So we'd had the 2 meals, then we ran through, was it 4 or 5 rounds total? 4?
4.
4? 5? Well, in the quarter turns at the beginning, so
4.5
rounds of posing, holding the poses for like 5, 7, 10 seconds on some even. So, you know, we went to the point that it felt like I'd been worked like a prejudge. I mean, we went through 4 rounds, which would be the equivalent of, you know, coming to your individual, 2 rounds, sorry, 1 round in your numerical groups, and then 2 rounds in, say, you're in the first call out, 2 rounds of that together. So we went through that, holding the poses for quite a while. Until the point where we got my heart rate up and got a little bit of a sweat going, like I would, you know, just in prejudging. So we, you know, think that was good, push a little more, you know, final water out, get that detail and make sure all the food's going right where we want. And then usually what I would do after a morning prejudge is come back, eat a smaller meal, keep water a bit lower now that we forced a little out from that posing. And we'll just relax. We'll probably try and get a nap after we eat the 3rd meal here. And, just chill until we get to go get tanned again tonight. So I got one more coat, just be kind of like a light touch up before prejudging. So we'll probably head over there like 5 or 6 or so. And then we'll hang out at the host hotel for a bit. We'll go to prejudging and we'll fuck some shit up, right? So we'll catch you guys in a bit.
Justin, switch. So let's see what this is about.
Yeah.
Brandon and Rami are not in this call out.
Front double bicep.
Nick is and he is have very good condition. I mean, he's getting better and better.
Mm-hmm. His color is good too.
Mm-hmm. About for a long time now.
He can get a big feather in his cap. He takes out William Bonick. Or Hadi Chupan, that's a big feather in his cap at a young age of 26.
That's right.
It's not a done deal.
Different judges want to see different things.
That's true.
Different comparisons.
Yeah, I'm trying not to think like a judge. I'm just,
exactly, yeah.
My opinion is there's more to this story.
So Side tricep.
Sometimes it favors those guys. You get that little sheen. You see it's starting to shine.
Yep. Mm-hmm.
His muscles are popping more.
Yeah, Honor's getting better.
Mm-hmm.
Abdominals and thighs
right now.
Oh, yeah.
Relax. Thank you, gentlemen. Back in line, please.
I like Hunter's shape.
Yeah, yeah. Got beautiful shape.
One of those guys are going to be called back. With
Brandon and Rami.
We got Brandon and Rami, but one of those guys might come back up. We saw this a year ago, Tim.
What is up, guys? We're back. It is Saturday evening, I guess now, really. I can do this after.
Keep going.
We're here just getting our final tan before finals. So we had pre-judging last night. I look like I'm sitting somewhere in, if I had to be realistic, I think I'm like a dead seventh right now. But there's a lot of guys that are, I think I can beat tonight if I work really hard for it. I think I'm close to Hunter, and I think if he's off a little bit tonight and I work hard and be a little sharper, I think I can get by that into the top six. You know, we'll think that one into existence like we did at the Arnold. So that's the goal for tonight. Get up into that top six, get those comparisons, and work hard for it and fight for it and get up in that group, right? So we're going to get the color right like we did yesterday, and we'll be back shortly. So we'll see you guys soon. What is up, guys? We're back here. It's a couple days after the Olympia now, and just wanted to talk to you guys and kind of, you know, recap and touch base on, you know, the whole weekend, the experience, and you know, I also hope you guys enjoyed, you know, kind of seeing behind the scenes on some of these shows this year with the Arnold and the Olympia this week. So, but yeah, we ended up seventh place, which is the same as last year, and I feel good about it. I'm happy with the package I brought. You know, I would have liked to obviously be in that first call out. You know, that's obviously the goal, is to continue moving up, but it's a different lineup than last year. And I'm very happy with the improvements I made, especially after a long season. You know, this was my fourth show of the year. I've been going since February, really. So very happy with how things ended up. And it's a good, you know, I had the idea of maybe doing some shows post-Olympia and getting my qualification out of the way. And, you know, there's a show in Egypt. There's a couple in Europe. There's Toronto Pro at the end of the year. But I think really the best option for me now is just to, you know, mostly mentally unwind, just like, you know, get my head out of that space of like go, compete. And I think I might have honestly been using it just as like a thing to kind of like escape the reality of like having to go back to normal life. You know, it was just like having those immediate goals continuously was really keeping me focused and driven. But I think, you know, best option now is just to hang it up for the year. We'll get into the off season and we'll come back next year even better. You know, there's lots of improvements to be made. I mean, you know, even when you're placing top 10 in the world, there's still lots of things to improve on. So, you know, back to the drawing board. You know, we'll get into this off season, and, you know, there's things we need to work on still. I mean, you know, the chest depth and the front shots, you know, the posing still needs lots of work. So, you know, there's lots of things to be done. And I'm happy we're still down here in Florida, you know, where I have, you know, lots of great people to train with. I have Ron Revive and, you know, all these great resources at my fingertips. So, to be down here, I think is going to be a great place for me to stay focused and stay motivated into this off season. So, thank you everyone for, you know, all the support and for tagging along for all these shows and, you know, the support I've received on these YouTube videos and, you know, even from the first one, just like the basic training videos, you know, the support was phenomenal. So, you know, I thank you guys all for that. You know, obviously I'm going to try and keep putting out as much videos as I can for you guys. So, you know, obviously the off season is quite exciting, is when you're prepping for the Arnold and the Olympia, but, there's still lots of things that we can showcase and talk about and, you know, obviously put in the comments anything you guys want to see from me, you know, from days of eating to, you know, off-season training, you know, how my split changes, whatever. You know, I'll try and get all this kind of stuff for you. So, yeah, but thank you guys for tagging along. It's been an awesome season, and we'll catch you next time.